Hey, in this video, we'll take a look at the EasyPresso K Pro Coffee Grinder. Hey, welcome to a new video. I'm the hobby barista, and in this video, we will take a look at one of the best manual grinders out there, the EasyPresso K Pro. We'll go over the design, the specs, and you will see it in action. I will show you the grinding process in real time, so stay tuned for that. I will also show you an espresso shot made with this grinder. And yeah, just to be sure, this video isn't sponsored, it's just my personal review. The grinder cost me about 260 euros, and I can already tell you it outperforms a lot of the grinders I worked with before. First, let's take a look at the grinder and all the accessories it comes with. It comes in a nice handy bag, so you can easily take the grinder with you everywhere you go, whether it be on a vacation or just to hang out with friends. And the bag contains the grinder, the handle, a brush, and an air puffer to clean the grinder. And it also comes with a nice graph, which gives you an impression of all the grind settings. I use it only for espresso, so I will be working within the 2 to 4 range. The first impression is just amazing. The design is just beautiful, and the weight allows you to feel the great build quality. And I can already feel it just fits my hand perfectly. So now let's just go into the specs a bit more. The K Pro is made mostly out of stainless steel, and the knob is made of high quality wood. And the size of the knob and the handle is just great and make it very comfortable to use. And it's very easy to put together and to dismantle. You just rotate the lower part of the grinder to loosen and fasten it. And it contains a stainless steel burr set with 90 clicks. And each click shifts the grind by 22 microns. And it gives you more than enough room to perfect the shot. So whether you want to do pour over, espresso or Turkish, it will give you plenty of options to choose from. And I really like the grind adjustment, which they placed on the external part of the grinder, so you don't have to open the whole thing to adjust the grind setting. You just rotate the upper rim and using the numbers as your guideline. And these make it very easy to replicate your results over and over for a consistent result. The handle and base of the grinder are very sturdy, which minimize the wiggling. And this has a very positive impact on the quality and consistency of the grinds. So now let's pour in some beans, and I'll show you the grinding process. And I will show you the grinding process in real time. And I only use it for double shots of espresso, which usually takes me about 50 to 60 seconds. And if you use it for pour over, I imagine it will take you maybe half a minute or so. So now we're done, we just pull off the handle and twist the lower or upper end until it comes off. And there's always some ground coffee sticking to the burrs. And the first thing I do is put the upper part straight into my portafilter and shake the stuck grounds off. And then I just pour the rest of the ground coffee straight into my portafilter. And I always use the brush to remove the grounds that are still stuck, just to clean it a bit and to make sure I get as much coffee in the portafilter as I can. You should make sure you never clean it with water. Just use the brush and the puffer to clean the grinder, and maybe the occasional treatment with something like Kafisa grinds. Alright, so now you've seen the grinding process, we can take a look at the quality of the grinds. And as you can see, it's very consistent, and I'm actually blown away by the results. And I can really taste it as well, because it makes the best espresso I've ever tasted. Combined with my Becerra BZ10, it really gives me creamy and clear shots. Yeah, I can talk about that for a while, but let's just take a look at the shot coming out of the espresso machine. To round up, I can just say that I'm very happy with this grinder. I find it a pleasure to use it on a daily basis, and actually made it the only grinder I use every day. And I've yet to discover any flaws or negative things. So I would really recommend this grinder to anyone. And I hope I gave you a good impression of the grinder, what it's capable of. And if you have any questions or comments, please let me know down below. And I hope you liked the video. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe. And I hope to see you in the next video.